this bone right here is going to be your humerus. This round, smooth portion up here is going to be the head of the humerus. Well, the head of the humerus, see this nice round section, that's going to articulate with what? What does it connect to? Hopefully you're thinking it connects to the glenoid fossa, forming your shoulder joint. So it articulates with the glenoid fossa of the scapula. Now, right below the head, or just a little more distally, this area right here, which goes around below the head, is going to be the anatomical neck. Makes sense, head's on the neck, so sure. But we also have a surgical neck. That's more down in this area, the surgical neck. If we go back up to where the head is facing medial. We have these bumpy protrusions facing lateral. Now if we turn this a little bit so you're looking at the lateral side, you can notice how there's a small protrusion here and a much larger protrusion over here. The much larger protrusion is known as the greater tubercle. So this is the greater tubercle. While this smaller protrusion, that is known as the lesser tubercle. So larger, greater tubercle, smaller, lesser tubercle. Now since they're all rough, what do you think their purpose is? Why do we have them? The purpose of these tubercles are for muscular attachment, tendons, or even ligament attachments. Now in between the two tubercles, there's this indent. There's this groove right here. That groove is known as the intertubercular groove. The intertubercular groove. And if you follow that intertubercular groove down, you're going to find a rough patch about a third to halfway down the shaft of the bone. This rough patch is going to be the deltoid tuberosity. Just think where your deltoid muscle is. It's on the lateral side of your shoulder. It kind of goes down aiming towards the elbow. But before it gets there, about part of the way down the arm, it goes into more of a triangular shape and dives deep to attach the bone right here, the deltoid tuberosity. Now, if we move from the proximal end to the distal end, the distal end of the bone is going to have your condyles and epicondyles. Now down here, we can see there is a rounded portion right here, and then another smooth indent here. This rounded portion is known as the capitulum. Now you look at the root word capitate. Now think about what capitate means. Capitate means round, like head. Think about decapitate, cut off the head. So capitulum, that's rounded like a head, round. This area right next to it from here to here, you can see how it kind of dips in and back up. It's almost like an old wooden spool of thread, wider on the edges, narrower in the middle. This is called the trochlea. Now we know the trochlea is going to be on the medial side of the bone because the head is on the medial side of the bone. The capitulum is on the lateral side of the bone. If you go just above the capitulum, there's a small little indent here. So a little indent that's just proximal to the capitulum. That is going to be your radial fossa. The slight indent right here, which is just proximal to the trochlea, that is the coronoid fossa. So again, watch this one. It's the coronoid fossa. Now if we flip over to the posterior side, we're going to see this larger indent back here. This larger indent is going to be the olecranon fossa. Olecranon fossa. So now we need to figure out, is this a left or a right humerus? Well, we know the head has to be facing medially. We know that the head must be proximal. So the only thing we have to figure out then is, does it sit like this on the right side? Or does it sit like this on the left side? The answer is, this is a right humerus. The last giveaway, the olecranon fossa must point posteriorly. It has to point towards the back. So this is going to be your right humerus.